Hello everyone, welcome to my channel and thank you for watching. I've been getting lots of messages recently asking why, when you clear the cache on some Fire TV devices, this happens. You clear it to zero, but when you go back in, it's gone back up to 16.38 kilobytes. I hope this video will give you the answers you are looking for. So when you're ready, let's go and take a look. You can use the clickable sections below to skip ahead to any specific part in this video. If you're looking for a new VPN service, why don't you check out the links in the description below this video. Clicking on these links can not only give you a great discount off of your next VPN subscription, but clicking through these links also helps to support my channel. If you skipped the intro, a quick recap of the issue. On some Fire TV devices, this is happening. You clear the cache only to go back in and find it has jumped back up to 16.38 kilobytes. So first, let's talk about cache. Cache is a temporary storage space that retains files, images, and other important data from web browsers and apps. Cache is actually a good thing to have and is important because it improves the speed and efficiency in retrieving data. When an app is opened, things like video thumbnails and images are downloaded and stored as very small blocks of cache. So next time you open the app, the images are already there in your device memory, so they can be quickly retrieved and the app loads faster. If you clear the cache, the next time you open the app, images and other app data have to be downloaded again, making the app load slower. The problem with Fire TV devices is that they have a very small amount of storage space. And over time, some caches can build up to large amounts and take up valuable storage space. Such as the Fire TV screensaver, for example, if you haven't already turned it off. But you probably have already done that if you've watched my previous video on recommended Fire TV settings to turn off. In instances where cache has built to a large amount, you may want to clear it as it can affect your device performance if it starts to run low on storage. On Fire TV devices such as the 4K Fire Stick, clearing the cache has never been an issue. You go in, clear the cache, and it resets to zero. On newer Fire TV devices such as the new 4K Max and the Fire Cube second generation, where this doesn't happen and the cache jumps back up to 16.38 kilobytes after you've cleared it, this has been causing a few concerns and reports of faulty or buggy Fire Sticks. 16.38 kilobytes is a very tiny and insignificant amount of data and will not have any impact on your storage. A staff member from Amazon support has said that it is normal for the cache of any app to increase by a few kilobytes of data so that the app can search for automatic updates or reload the system data that is necessary. Seeing 16.38 kilobytes of cached data remaining after you clear the cache is nothing to be concerned about. It's a tiny amount of required system and application data. You haven't got a buggy or faulty Fire Stick. In fact, this also occurs on other devices too, such as my Meikle KM7 and Nvidia Shield TV. Going into any application and clearing the cache always leaves around 16.38 kilobytes of cached data. Now, I'm certainly no expert on coding, operating systems, or caches, but from what I have been able to discover, this residual amount of cache keeps things like app permissions and app data retained to make your device and apps run better and faster. If I'm wrong, or if you have any further information you would like to share, drop me a comment below this video. As always, thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to hit that thumbs up button, comment and subscribe to my channel, making sure that you turn on notifications so you don't miss out on any of my latest releases. These small actions from you make a big difference to me and helps to improve how YouTube recommends my videos to potential subscribers, and I truly appreciate your help in making my channel grow. There's also a brand new thanks button YouTube have added that allows you to show your appreciation even more to your favourite YouTubers with an animated super thanks.